We've of course played better and we've practiced better than we played tonight. It's as simple as that. And I like to say that it was all us and what we didn't do, but you have to give North Carolina a lot of credit. They played well all three phases. Offensively, kept us off, you know, off balance with the run and the pass. Did a great job with that. We talked about, you know, we know we need to take the ball away, and we didn't do a good job of that tonight. Other side of the ball, miscues really hurt us. You know, when you jump out to a lead and you have momentum, you have to take advantage of that. But offensively, we never could really, you know, get anything going, anything consistently done, I should say. Penalties really hurt us. I mean, we're a more disciplined football team than that. It seemed like everyone really gave them momentum. The other guys fought hard, and we stayed in there. Even though we weren't playing our best ball, you know, we were within striking range right up until the end when they hit a couple big ones. But we'll learn from it. I thought we were ready for prime time, and we're not quite there yet, but we'll get there. We'll learn an awful lot from this game. Had a couple of injuries, Caleb Day and Gabe Megason. Don't know the extent. Whenever you don't finish a football game, of course, there's concern. I'll take your question.
Yeah, sellout crowd first since 2011. Do you feel like this was a missed opportunity to get more people bought in?
Well, it's a missed opportunity, yes. I mean, just for a football team here. But I think our fans kind of see where we are. Again, as I said, I thought we were ready to take that next step. We're not quite there yet, but we'll get there. One game. I think Wes performed the way all of us performed. You know, I have to do a lot better job than that. To a man, we all have to. Wes was a part of that. He would like to have some passes back. Those turnovers really hurt us. But we were just off a little bit, Wes and everyone else tonight.
In terms of getting ready for a front, you said not quite there yet, ready for prime time. What needs to get done to get there?
Everything. It's just not a simple answer I can give you. Tonight, it takes all three phases of playing top ball, winning the turnover ratio, limiting penalties. So tonight, it was just, you know, everything. We didn't do some things well that we really need to. And the things that we'll do better in the past, we didn't do enough.
You know, it did look like, Larry, that you were maybe ready for prime time at the start, because you came out, you hit the long run, and then came back after they scored and scored again. Can you think of anything that happened in there that began to turn it their direction a little bit?
No, when I say we're not ready for prime time, I'm talking about finishing the job
right on
prime time. No, we came out, I thought there was good energy, I thought the guys were in a great frame of mind going into the game, but you have to maintain that, and it's what you do the entire 60 minutes. That's what I was disappointed in. We had our moments throughout. Big stop right before the half to give us some momentum going in. There were some momentum swings throughout, but we never took advantage of any of them.
Did you talk about your punt team performance tonight?
I'm sorry?
Your punt team.
Trying to run away from our guys. Pretty much the same with everything. Punt team, punt return team, we didn't get much out of it. Punt team, though, I mean, switcher didn't run a lot. You know, didn't take a long one back, but again, nothing was on par tonight.
Is there a reason Ryan Frame wasn't a punter today?
Ryan Frame was in an accident yesterday. A biking accident, so he wasn't able to play.
Can you tell us about Gabe?
Sorry?
How's Gabe doing?
I mean, after the game, it's not a whole lot to tell. He didn't finish the game. We'll let you know a little bit later on. Even when a guy can't finish, you know, that's all he really needs.
Is Frain something long term?
He should be okay. He's okay with the football team now, but there's an injury that didn't allow him to play.
How do you let this game not define the rest of your
season? You know, I mean, we've been in this long enough to know that you can't get too high on a big win and too low on a tough loss like, you know, normally it's somewhere in between. But when you have a tough loss like this, you should feel bad, which we do. And know that there's some things we have to correct. But the last time I checked, this count was one loss.
Is loss hurting you more knowing that it came in front of a sellout and some of
the fans? A loss is a loss, you know? And if you lose, there's one person out there that's going to hurt the same way. Same mistakes that we made tonight, we will be correcting them tomorrow, whether it's one or a sellout crowd.
Probably a lot made of what the atmosphere might be like tonight. What was your impressions of it when the game was beginning there?
I thought the fans were outstanding. I mean, that's the only phase of, you know, there's four phases, you know, offense, defense, special teams, and of course, the fans. They did their job, simple as that. But for our players, I mean, this is good for us to see what it eventually will be once we're playing top-notch ball. This is a university that can draw people like that and have that type of atmosphere. We had a lot of players here, a lot of recruits here today watching. And I think what they saw is that they saw a team that's building. It wasn't quite there tonight, but hopefully get there soon.
Even though it's a non-conference loss, what positives are you taking away from this? Where you can build for next
week? Well, I think positives you take, I mean, it's a learning experience. I mean, the mistakes that we made, I mean, we see what happens when you do some things that we did tonight. We're going to go back to penalties. I mean, when you're playing a good football team, you need to be on top of your game. You can't turn the ball over. You need to win the turnover ratio. And you can't make a whole lot of penalties like that. So these situations should help us going forward. Initial stage of our program on what we're trying to do, but we'll learn from these things tonight.
How do you explain those penalties? Is it just kind of you
don't explain. I mean, if you have a penalty, how do you explain? Don't do it. You know, we preach it. Believe me, when I preach it, Nick, we don't want the guys to do it. But sometimes you have to see what they can do to your team. And tonight, we saw what a penalty and another penalty can do. Penalties on top of penalties, but Denzel can't do it. Winning teams don't do it. We'll clean it up.
Well, you averaged about 3.6 yards per pass. What did North Carolina do that frustrated passing?
They got pressure. I mean, they covered us. And that's pretty much it. I just don't think it was anything else that they did. Not a whole lot of stuff that we didn't know about. I mean, they executed plays and came through. Times when they needed to. Air it downs and different things like that.
Any further questions for Coach?
Thank you.
All right, thank you. Players will be available in the player lounge down the hall.